perfect. You can test drive.
Of the death of the great Soapy Smith. The School for Scoundrels and the Magic Castle is very proud to present Soapy Smith Night. You have just been listening to Dave Bourne, Professor Dave Bourne, a wonderful piano player from the Gem Saloon. The finest acts of its kind in the whole world. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the two-time national trick shot champion at pool, Chef Anton.
For example, the gentleman right on over here. If I were to bet you right now I could shoot an entire game of pool using nothing more than, let's say, that little piece of thread for my shirt, would you be willing to bet against me?
Yeah.
Shoot an entire game of pool using nothing more than that little piece of thread. You would? You should never take a bet against a con man, a hustler, and a swindler, because while it'd be impossible for me to shoot using a piece of thread, it's not impossible if I actually change it into a $1,500. How to do that, you'll never pay for a beer again for the rest of your life. Actually, you know what, Paul? It's in the book. The secret's in the book. You'll be able to hustle all these people unless they buy their copy after the show's over.
Tape?
Yeah, she's on the tape too. Not that you'll be able to do it, but it is on the tape. Now we're going to take another triangle. Place it on top of the three balls. And yet another three balls. Just that. You know, sir, I remember the first time I stacked this up and it didn't come crashing down. I was so shocked, I too forgot to applaud.
In 1935, when the first biographies on Soapy came out, the author was so inspired by Soapy that he, in front of the book, he put a little quote. It went something like this. He never missed an opportunity to separate the goatball from their calf. Neither did he ever miss an opportunity to preach and practice the gospel of kindliness and compassion. 1924, a gang member visited the wife of Soapy. And they talked about the old times. He got very intoxicated, and it was a little silent alone in the conversation. And he just looked up, he raised his glass, and he said, "Here's to Soapy's Ghost." And that's been our toast ever since 1974. So, Ashley, please.
Here's to Soapy's Ghost. Yeah.